Congress, ministers, vice ministers and secretaries, ambassadors and chiefs of missions, representatives of the civil society and the private sector, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen. It is my pleasure to address this ministerial dialogue at a critical juncture where the world is struggling to emerge from the COVID-19 pandemic. This is a very special moment to share our views and renew our commitments. As a member of the V20, we perceive this meeting as a platform for dialogue on future-proofing economic development, building on the spirit and initiatives of partnership for planetary prosperity. Partnerships have been crucial to Timor-Leste's recent history. From the birth of our nation, the restoration of independence 19 years ago, and throughout the development trajectory, the work and experience of partnerships have been significant for a country arising out of destruction and long suffering. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, more than 70% of Timorese live in remote rural areas with little infrastructure. Their lives and livelihoods are significantly impacted by climate-related events such as floods, landslides, erosion, rapid deforestation and forest degradation, sea level rise and droughts increasing in intensity in recent years. We as a nation are committed to global efforts in mitigation and adaptation of risks arising from natural disasters induced by climate change in achieving climate resilience. To that effort, we are partnering with the Green Climate Fund and trusted international delivery partners, namely UNDP and GIECA, to implement projects to address these challenges. The year 2020 was particularly the most challenging one. After two consecutive years of negative growth, the recovery in 2019 was not enough to create productive and decent jobs, raise incomes, and reduce inequalities. But Timor-Leste must recover its economy and return its growth trajectory toward more inclusive development with people at the center where no one is left behind. I believe that this can be realized because partnerships have produced results. The V20 was established on the principles of partnership for an alternative economic model that promotes climate resilience and low carbon growth in the most vulnerable economies, and herewith I congratulate the presidency of V20 Bangladesh on showing the way forward through Mujib Climate Prosperity Plan for the decade till 2030. Timor-Leste endorses the demand for enhanced support to the 12 key priorities identified in the Vision 2025. We all know that the COVID-19 pandemic has exposed serious vulnerabilities across many countries, and Timor-Leste is not an exception. A robust starting point to meet these 12 priorities to systematically dealing with risks that both the International Monetary Fund and the World Bank Group could pursue together with V20 economies in building back from the COVID-19 pandemic, aiming to address macro-financial risks and need for investments in mitigation, adaptation, and climate-resilient development. Furthermore, I believe there is a scope for more trade and investment partnerships, and also for support to reduce the cost of capital to drive resilience investments. Timor-Leste joins its fellow V20 members with the support of the International Monetary Fund and the World Bank Group in inviting G20 to explore these opportunities for mutual benefit. With these words, on behalf of the government of Timor-Leste, we join in solidarity to global efforts to reach planetary prosperity, to maximize socioeconomic outcomes and economic growth. I thank you.